What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today we're reviewing the Tesla Model 3 from 2022. But before, make sure you guys hit like, make sure you guys go watch my YouTube shorts, and subscribe to the channel. Very important. This is the entry-level sedan from Tesla. The second premium version from Tesla is the Tesla Model S. But this one, it's not just the regular entry-level Model 3. This one is the dual motor, which comes with 335 to 350 miles of range. And it retails for about $50,000. You can probably find one today for about 40, 45, but usually that's what they go for. This is a very, very exciting vehicle. It's actually very fast. This is almost as fast as a Lamborghini Huracan. So yeah, let me tell you and show you everything about it. So on this specific model, you get 19-inch wheels all around. The calipers do say Tesla on the inside. You get these very fancy door handles, which you push over here and pull to open the door. And right behind that over here, you have your charging port, which you can just tap to open, and it shows you the charging port. You do the same thing to close. If you go to the back, you have your Tesla signature taillights, and you have the dual motor badge right in the back. Let's open the trunk, shall we? So as you guys can see, there's a lot of trunk space, enough for about 3 suitcases. And right under, you have your charging cable and your adapter. Okay, this is a Tesla standard charger. And Teslas are very easy to charge. All you have to do once you set up your Tesla account, you have your credit card information on there. All you have to do is pull up to the Tesla charging station and just plug in your vehicle, just like you were charging your phone at home. To close the trunk, all you have to do is just press the button over here. And voila. Another thing to point out, you have your side markers, also with a camera over here on each side. You also get LED headlights and fog lights. Every Tesla also comes with a polarized all glass roof, as you guys can see. And all Teslas also come with a very interesting infotainment system. I've already shown you the exterior of the car. Now we're gonna go to the interior and show you everything about it. On the door panels, you get this very premium Alcantara and leather. Right here, you have your regular window switches, and this is your door actuator to open the doors. You actually get a very nice storage space over here with a cup holder. To open the door on the Teslas, all you have to do is just press this button right here, and the door opens. If for any reason that button does not work, there's another way to open the door, and it's this little latch over here, which you just pull up, as you guys can see, and you get that message on the screen. Just make sure you use the actuator instead of that, okay?
Oh, okay!
You actually get premium sound on the Tesla. I'm not exactly sure what type of branding the stereo system is. I believe it's in-house, but it sounds fantastic. I have no complaints on the sound whatsoever. I think it sounds amazing. Also, the steering wheel feels very nice to the touch. You have your turn signals, just like a regular car. And if you press the button, you get your windshield wipers and your windshield wiper menu right here, which you can adjust the speed of the windshield wipers, as you guys can see, but I like to keep it in auto. And on the right over here, you have your gear selector. As you guys can see, you have reverse, neutral, and drive. And to put the car in drive, all you have to do is press the accelerator, push all the way down for drive, all the way up for reverse, and press the button on the side for park. There are 3 ways you can use a Tesla key and one is using your phone as a key when you pair your phone to the car. The other one is a card that they give you as a side key, and the regular standard Tesla key. As long as you have that with you, you can just put the foot in the brake, put the car in drive, and it'll go. It's very simple. You have a glove box over here, just like any other car. You have two wireless charging, storage space, two cup holders, and right over here, some more storage space. One thing that I must mention is that the sun visor, right here you have your mirror. It feels very premium. This is magnetic, as you guys can see. You have your rear view mirror right over here. Reading lights that you can just tap to turn on and off. And your hazard lights. There's a lot of complaints on the build quality of the Teslas. I personally haven't experienced anything out of the ordinary, anything that's, you know, bad quality. I think it feels very premium in here. Although these side pillars over here feels very plasticky. But other than that, the car feels great. And like I mentioned earlier, it has a 10 speaker sound system that sounds fantastic. I love it. The audio quality is great. And yeah, I have no complaints on it. In the back of the Tesla, you got the same Alcantara door panels and plenty of space for three adults, which can sit in the back comfortably. You have your AC vents right over here and storage space right behind your seat. All right, guys, so this is the infotainment system on the Tesla. It's a 15-inch screen. And as you guys can see, you can use these buttons over here to open the front, to lock and unlock the doors, open the trunk, and you can even open the charging port right from over here. Right here, you have your selector, whether you're in park, reverse, neutral, or drive. And right over here on the right, you have your battery level. Right now, we're currently at 82. And if we tap, it tells you how many miles we have left. If you swipe up right over here, you have your media where you can switch between Bluetooth, Spotify, radio, Apple Music, or you can, you know, adjust your sound settings, as you guys can see. And you can just scroll down to close. On the right of the screen, you have your navigation. As you guys can see, it's very responsive. You have no Apple CarPlay and no Android Auto. This is Tesla's integrated navigation system. It's very responsive and it works great. And right over here, if you see that little lightning bolt, if you tap it, it'll show you all the charging stations around your area. You can select whether you want the regular charging or the supercharger with the three lightning bolts. That's the one that I recommend. Because I care for your safety and the safety of others, is that if you go to a charging station to charge a Tesla, make sure you're in a good area. If you're in a bad area, let's say you were to get mugged and your vehicle is connected to the charging station, your car is not going anywhere. There's no way you can detach from it in time. The car is gonna be stuck in park and you're just gonna be, you know, a chicken in a cage. Charging the Tesla can take anywhere between 25 to 45 minutes, sometimes even longer. Once you select your charging station, I recommend that you navigate and use the navigation system to the supercharger. That way it preconditions the battery. And that way when you're charging the car, it takes a lot less time to charge the vehicle. On the top of the screen, as you can see over here, you have your time, outside temperature. The vehicle is currently recording any, for security purposes, and you have your driver profile right over here. Right over here, you have your AC controls. You just tap, and you can move the airflow wherever you want it to go for both the passenger and the driver. This is a pretty cool feature I've never seen in any other car, and it's pretty cool from Tesla. You can turn on and off your AC, select where you want the AC to go. You also get the rear passenger settings. You have heated seats in the passenger. As you can see, you have three settings for that. Let me turn it all off at once. You also have the dog mode In case you have a dog inside the car, you just tap the dog mode and the cabin will make sure to stay nice and cool for the dog. Like I mentioned, you have heated seats front and back. You also have heated steering wheel and heated windshield in case you live in a snowy area. Right over here on the bottom left, you have your vehicle settings, as you guys can see. You can select whether you want your lights to be in automatic. You can fold the mirrors, put the shower lock on and off, open the glove box, lock the windows, windshield wiper settings, adjust the mirrors and steering wheel. And that's something I need to show you guys. So let me zoom out a little bit. So to adjust the mirrors on the Tesla, click on the mirror. And with this little wheel over here, you're gonna go up and down. As you guys can see over here, you can see the mirror going up or down, left and right. You exit out, and it's the same thing for the steering wheel. See, you just use the wheel up and down, left and right to telescope. Very simple. And right over here in the bottom, you can select the brightness of the screen. If you go one setting down, you have your acceleration, steering mode, or stopping mode. Acceleration, if you put it in chill mode, the vehicle will accelerate very slowly. If you put it in standard, this one being a dual motor, you will have a blast. It is very, very fast, and I will demonstrate that in a little bit. The steering mode, I like to keep it in sport. That gives me nice and sturdy steering feel. And stopping mode, if you put it in hold, and once you remove your foot from the accelerator, the vehicle will come slowly to a stop. If you put it in roll, the vehicle will continue to roll just like a regular car. And if you put it in creep, once you remove your foot from the brake, the vehicle will slowly start to move. The third option is charging, where you can select whether you want to charge to 100% or 80%. The recommended for daily driving is 80%. Anything after 80 is pretty much considered something like a reserve energy. I always like to charge up to 100. And as you guys can see right over here, the last paid charging session cost me $17.16. That was a charging from 20% all the way to 95%. So that's how much it costs, almost $20, which is very cheap. And right over here on the screen, I'm gonna put the supercharging tips, which I always use. And the rest of the options, as you guys can see, is the autopilot. You can set a, you know, a fixed speed or selected, you know, speed that you want. You have your light settings right over here. Display settings. Navigation settings. I like to have the cabin heat protection on, always to keep the vehicle cool and not extremely hot when it's parked outside on the sun. And the last option is the service. It'll tell you the PSI on each four tires, the amount of miles you have before you can take the vehicle back to service. You can adjust your headlights, check your wheel and tires, camera preview, calibrate the camera, and as you guys can see, all the other settings. You have to make sure if you take your car to the car wash, you click on car wash mode and put the vehicle in car wash. As you guys can see, it'll tell you the reasons why you need this setting. And right here, you can upgrade the software on the car. You can check all the software, you know, download new software, and stuff like that. On the bottom right, you have your sound, and you can tap right here to show you all the sound settings. This is how I always like to keep my sound settings. And in the bottom, you have all the apps. And you can go ahead and also download more apps, but as you guys can see, I have Spotify. You have Zoom, you have Dashcam, Energy, Arcade, where you can play video games, Toy Box, which will do a whole bunch of all the different things, which I will show you soon, and Bluetooth to connect your phone. You have your radio settings right here also, as you guys can see. All right, let's turn that down. If you go to Arcade, it's very cool. And let me zoom out so I can show you how you can play the games on this car. All right, guys, so I'm gonna show you a demo of a video game inside of a Tesla. This one being my favorite. It's called Beach Buggy Racing 2. So you just tap play game. This is... pick one player. And we're gonna use ludicrous mode. So one of the fun things about this game is that you can actually use the steering wheel to turn the car, and that's why my kids love this game. So let me demonstrate. So, as you guys can see, it's very fun. Oops, I crashed. Tell me of another car that can do this. So you guys can see, I'm not that great, but, whoa. I think you can even, yep, you can use your brakes and it'll brake the car too. There's no other car that can play games like this. I mean, it's just fun. So you can do this while charging the car, you know, while you're waiting for somebody, or you know, you're just spending time inside the car. You can just entertain yourself and your kids, you know? All right, so that was a little demo. So that's it. To close the game, you just swipe down and you're back to the home screen. So other fun things about the Tesla, if you go over here to Toy Box, you have all these selection of cool things that the car can do. You have the rainbow road that, you know, it will change the way the navigation looks, same thing for Santa and Mars. It's to customize your navigation features. You have a sketchpad. Let's say you're trying to get cozy in the car with your significant other. You can go over here and you can play a fire pit. As you guys can see, that's pretty cool. Double tap to turn off. You also have tracks, that's to make beats. emissions, it will play fart sounds all throughout the cabin. So you can put it on the passenger seat and it will play a fart sound. Same thing for the driver's seat or the rear passengers. You also have the boombox, which allows you to play media outside of the car. Light show, which I'll show demonstrate now. The vehicle needs to be in park for the light show to start. So we'll put it in park. We got a light show. Park inside and get a show. And so now confirm. All right, let's go see. The windows go down. Windows go up and down. That was pretty cool, guys. So the car rolls the windows up and it locks up. And colorizer, which allows you to change the color of the vehicle over here. These are a black car, so obviously I'm gonna leave it on as black. All right, guys, so we're gonna drive the Tesla now. You can watch the speed right over here. Right over here. Make sure we put the seat belts on. This car is so fast, it's unbelievable. Okay, we're gonna stop right here on zero. Just watch this speed. 1, 2, 3. Let's go. Oh my God. From zero. Man. Yeah, this car is really, really fast, guys. Really, really fast. Shh. you can't get tired of that. It's really, really fun. All right, let's hit it one more time. Tired of that, guys. You can't get tired. There's nothing that can beat this. Nothing. I mean, this is as fast as a Lamborghini can go. It's just pure fun. It just throws you back into the seat. Let's make a U-turn over here. Hit it one more time. The only thing that I don't like about Teslas is that you can't disable the traction control completely. So you're not able to do burnouts and donuts or anything like that. All of that is out of the question. But man, that the feeling of speed is amazing. Make sure we're good. We have nobody ahead of us. And hit it. Speed, but not enough brakes. That's one thing I don't like about the Tesla. It's very, very fast. It is extremely fast, but the brakes, it's just not there. Unless you get like a performance model that has bigger brakes, then yes. But this one, the brakes, it's not enough for this car. You're going 140 miles an hour and then you need to stop. You better make sure you have enough space. But yeah, you can get tired of this. Oh man. Just testing out the brakes. Yeah, the brakes are not the best. But yeah, still a very fun car. I love driving it. I'll still prefer, you know, a gasoline engine. But yeah. Still a fun car to drive. I recommend it. This is the kind of car, if you're an authentic car guy, if you're into cars, a Tesla is not something you will buy. This is for that person that wants to have the latest model iPhone, the latest model Apple Watch, and there's just, you know, not to say the word, but they like technology, right? So this car is for that type of person. But me, I mean, I like to enjoy it. I like to drive it. You know, but I still prefer, you know, I prefer the noise, you know. I like to have a noise, nice muscle car with a V8. That's my thing. You know, I do care about other people's safety. So all the driving that I did at really high speed is in a very secluded area. There's no, you know, no homes nearby. There's no cars around me or anything like that. So, yeah. All right, guys, so that is it on the Tesla Model 3. Thank you for watching the video. Again, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Make sure you hit the like button. Make sure you comment. And go watch my shorts because I have a lot of vehicles on there. Again, I'll see you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching. Peace out.